Well, we're walking along a boardwalk at St. Kilda, which is near Adelaide in South Australia. And the species that is growing here is Avicennia marina, and it's the only one that can grow in the extreme environment along this really dry coast. And there are high salinities in the coastal waters. And I'll swing around here. You can see that the trees at this upper end, the higher marsh, are quite stunted. They're only maybe a couple of meters, 3 meters at the most in height. And they're stunted because of the extreme conditions here, both the dry climate as well as high salinities in the waters and in the soil. Avicennia can tolerate high salinities because it has the capacity to get rid of salt through pumping out salt that has been taken up through the roots into its tissues. It pumps it out through salt glands that are in the leaves. And you can see here on this tree, you can see the salt crystals that have formed on the underside of this leaf. And then the next time it rains, or in some cases the tide comes up this high, the salt crystals will be washed off the leaf. So I'll pour a little water on this leaf. So you can see the salt crystals just wash right off. And this is at the upper edge of the mangrove forest where it's transitioning from salt marsh. And you can see a little bit of the salt marsh species, these succulents behind me. They're very low growing and their leaves and stems are very succulent, full of water, which is an adaptation for salinity and dry conditions.